This is just a super short video just to show you the tubs that I've been getting from a company called Oakland Gardens. If you've watched some of the UK channels dealing with gardens and gardening and so on, you may have seen these before. I know Tony from Simplified Gardening is always on about them because he uses them to plant his potatoes and so on. I've used exactly those pots to plant pretty much everything that you can see here. And it all does well. They're really robust and available in a load of sizes. I'll put the link to them in the video description. But I'll just quickly show you what I've got planted in mine. Now, I can't remember what size these are. That one might be 45 litres, but that's full of okra, which is New Zealand yam. It's going absolutely berserk in there. It's actually two of those pots. We've got one there, one there. And we've got all manner of kale in pots from probably about 35 or 30 litres maybe 30 litres for that one, again going all the way up to about 45 litres. And you can't even see the bloody pots. Look at this, man. The plants are going absolutely berserk in them. And what I do to keep the pigeons out of mine, I put a little bit of weld mesh around here. It's only 6 inches high, but it stops the pigeons getting on the side. As it happens, they haven't bothered with them. This stuff doesn't seem to be bothered by anything, actually. Even slugs don't seem to bother this, and it tastes lovely. So I can't understand why they don't like that. We had two cracking crops of peas from two pots here. Again, I think they're 40 or 45 litres, thereabouts. Doesn't really matter. These are past the best now, but they were absolutely laden with peas, as you can see, because we've got all the pea skins around here. We didn't actually put any on the table. I've just been eating them all over the last couple of weeks. Here we've got decent sized pots again. We've got peas in there, and we've got raspberries in there. We've got taties in the one behind them. Good, really good for taties. Now, with regard to planting the potatoes in the pots, that is a very, very successful way to grow a lot of potatoes in a very limited space. So you could even do that in a backyard or a balcony, you know, it doesn't take up much space at all. Now, Tony from Simplify Garden has already done a very good video of how to plant them up. He's the expert gardener, I am not, so I shall put a link to his video in the video description. More raspberries in here. Here we've got some skirret, we've got walking onions. There we've got some Jerusalem artichoke. We've got some Chinese artichoke behind them. Just really handy, you know, if I ever wanted to clear this area out, I just lift the pots out of the way. So we've just taken a quick jump up back to the pond filters. Hello, cat. And here we've got loads of pots set inside the filter, filled with something called hydroton, also known as clay pebbles or clay beads, planted up to do a specific job, which I'll explain in a different video. These pots are perfect for that purpose. Here we've got one that's empty that I'm just using as a bit of a trug. When I've been digging these taties out of here, I've just been putting the heads and any taties that I've stuck with a fork in there. Handles on the side are robust, which allow me to carry it quite easily. And they're pretty cheap as well, so I would definitely advise people get these at the end of the year when you've finished with whatever you've planted in them. Just empty that out. Stack them, they don't take up much space. They're just a good way to buy yourself a little bit more garden. And also the slugs and snails find it a little bit more difficult to get all the way up there into your plants than they do if you just got flat beds or even, you know, partially raised beds. I found the pots are a hell of a lot less predated than the ordinary garden. And really, it just takes a hell of a lot less work to look after anything in pots. At the time I got mine, I had bought other pots from previous folks online. The Oakland ones were cheaper and they were exactly the same. So, like you guys, I always go for good quality products at a cheap price. Check those ones out and I shall see you in the next video.